in a small Ohio town. 2,000 ribs were laid to rest in Yankee ground.
With the song Lady in Gray, Mark and I had talked about this song probably a year before we ever actually sat down to write it. And I went to Mark's home there one Saturday afternoon, my girlfriend Donna and I did, and we actually went to the cemetery and walked through it, and a cold winter day, I'm saying it was probably in the high 30s, maybe low 40s, and we all had coats on. Once we walked in that graveyard and started looking at everything, especially when I saw Private Allen's gravestone, I got such a warm feeling. And I told Mark, I said, this is going to be a great, great story. And so he called me, three or four months later and asked me, have you done anything to this song? Well, no, I actually haven't. And he said, ask me what I thought about getting Paula Breedlove involved. Well, this was my opportunity to get to work with Paula for the first time, and I was all for that. I've admired her work for a number of years. And once she sent us the lyrics, I know Mark mentioned earlier about one of the other songs. The melody kind of wrote itself. It just kind of laid itself out there for me. So it's hard for me to take credit for it, but I did write the melody to it. And a great song, beautiful song, a great story. And again, this is something that we were able to share. You know, we're able to share these stories with everyone involved.
Yeah, this was, and of course, I live near Columbus, Ohio, right where the camp, we're talking about Camp Chase, which was a Union prison, kind of a notorious prison, and I think there's over 2,000 Confederate soldiers buried, and now it's actually in a very urban part of Columbus, Ohio, where the prison no longer exists. It's been gone, but the graveyard is still there, and it's almost, you drive by it, you wouldn't even know it's there. So, and then to go inside and have this story about Stone 233, we went, and then being able to take the pictures of that marker and put it back with the story, it just brings it all real.
The only other thing I might add to that, the only disappointing part of this whole situation was the fact that when we went in the graveyard, there were no fresh flowers around any of the graves, which we had heard so much about her doing. And we missed out on that part of it. But being in that graveyard was just such a heartwarming situation for me. It left a lasting impression on me for sure.
There. And on moonlit nights on Stone 233, a ghostly figure dressed in gray can still be seen. And the lady in gray still mournfully cries, Stone 233, where her Benjamin lies. With flowers and tears, she grieves to this day for the soldier who loved the lady in gray. For the soldier who loved the lady in gray.
What are we doing, filming?